its glory. Out of a western town, she told a sad, sad story of the great ship that went down. 'Twas the 14th day of April, over the way she rolled, sailing into tomorrow, to a golden age foretold. The night was bright with starlight, the seas were sharp and clear, moving through the shadows, the promised hour was near. Lights were holding steady, gliding over the foam. All the lords and ladies heading for their eternal home. The chandeliers were swaying from the balustrades above. The orchestra was playing the songs of faded love. The watchman, he lay dreaming as the ballroom dancers twirled. He dreamed the Titanic was sinking into the underworld. Sketchbook, he was often so inclined. He closed his eyes and painted the scenery in his mind. Cupid struck his bosom and broke it with a snap. The closest woman to him, he fell into her lap. He heard a loud commotion, something sounded wrong. His inner spirit was saying that he couldn't stand here long. He staggered to the quarterdeck, no time now to sleep. Water on the quarterdeck, already 3 foot deep. Smokestack was leaning sideways, heavy feet began to pound. He walked into the whirlwind, the sky splitting all around. The ship was going under, the universe had opened wide. The roll was called up yonder, the angels turned aside. Lights down in the hallway, flickering dim and dull. Dead bodies already floating in the double bottom hull. The engines then exploded, propellers they failed to start. The boilers overloaded, the ship's bow split apart. Passengers were flying backward, forward, fine, fast. They mumbled, fumbled, and tumbled, each one more weary than the last. The veil was torn asunder between the hours of 12 and 1. No change, no sudden wonder could undo what had been done. The watchmen lay there dreaming at 45 degrees. He dreamed the Titanic was sinking, dropping to her knees. Wellington, he was sleeping, his bed
begin to slide. His valiant heart was beaten. He pushed the tables aside. Glass of shattered crystal lay scattered round about. He strapped on both his pistols. How long could he hold out? His men and his companions were nowhere to be seen. In silence there he waited for time and space to intervene. The passageway was narrow. There was blackness in the air. He saw every kind of sorrow, heard voices everywhere. Alarm bells were ringing to hold back the swelling tide. Friends and lovers clinging to each other side by side. Mothers and their daughters descending down the stairs, jumped into the icy waters. Love and pity sent their prayers. The rich man, Mr. Astor, kissed his darling wife. He had no way of knowing be the last trip of his life. Calvin, Blake and Wilson gambled in the dark. Not one of them would ever live to tell the tale or disembark. Brother rose up against brother in every circumstance. They fought and slaughtered each other in a deadly dance. They lowered down the lifeboats from the sinking wreck. There were traitors, there were turncoats, broken backs and broken necks. The bishop left his cabin to help all those in need. Turned his eyes up to the heavens, said the poor are yours to feed. Davy the brothel keeper came out, dismissed his girls. Saw the water getting deeper, saw the changing of his world. Jim Dandy smiled, he'd never learned to swim. Saw the little crippled child, and he gave his seat to him. He saw the starlight shining, streaming from the east. Death was on the rampage, but his heart was now in peace. They battened down the hatches, but the hatches wouldn't hold. They drowned upon the staircase of brass and polished gold. Leo said to Cleo, I think I'm going mad. But he lost his mind already, whatever mind he had. He tried to block the doorway to save all those from harm. Blood from an open wound pouring down his arm. Petals fell from flowers till all of them were gone. In the long and dreadful hours the wizard's curse played on. The host was pouring brandy, he was going down slow. He stayed right till the enemy was the last to go. There were many, many others, nameless here forevermore. They never sailed the ocean or left their homes before. The what's been here dreaming, the damage had begun. He dreamed the Titanic was sinking, and he tried to tell someone. Above him and beneath him, 50,000 tons of steel. He looked over at his compass, and he gazed into its face. Needle pointing downward, he knew he'd lost the race. In the dark illumination, he remembered bygone years. He read the book of Revelation, and he filled his cup with tears. When the Reaper's task had ended, 1600 had gone to rest. The good, the bad, the rich, the poor, the loveliest and the best. They waited at the landing, and they tried to understand, but there is no understanding for the judgment of God's hand. News came over the wires and struck with deadly force. Love had lost its fires, all things had run their course. The watchman, he lay dreaming of all things that can be. He dreamed the Titanic was sinking into the deep blue sea.